Many are the trials of the just, but from them all the Lord will rescue them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery.
Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent to Jeroboam, king of Israel, saying, Amos has conspired against you in the midst of the house of Israel. The land is not able to bear all his words. For thus Amos has said, Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel must go into exile, away from his land. And Amaziah said to Amos, O seer, go, flee away to the land of Judah, and eat bread there, and prophesy there. But never again prophesy at Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary, and it is a temple of the kingdom. Then Amos answered Amaziah, I am no prophet, nor a prophet's son, but I am a herdsman, and a dresser of sycamore trees. And the Lord took me from following the flock, and the Lord said to me, Go prophesy to my people Israel. Now, therefore, hear the word of the Lord. You say, Do not prophesy against Israel, and do not preach against the house of Isaac. Therefore, thus says the Lord, Your wife shall be a harlot in the city, and your sons and daughters shall fall by the sword, and your land shall be parceled out by none. You yourself shall die in an unclean land. And Israel shall surely go into exile away from its land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just.
The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just.
The law of the Lord is perfect, it revives the soul. The rule of the Lord is to be trusted, it gives wisdom to the simple.
The decrees of the Lord are truth, and law for the just.
The precepts of the Lord are right, they gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear. than honey from the comb.
The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just.
Alleluia.
Ourselves for and repair the sins of our brethren.
We do this as well for those who have lapsed and left the church, that through our prayers and God's mercy they might be brought back to the ark of salvation. We do this also for ourselves, that God's mercy might be poured out on our hearts, and that we might be converted back to God. We do not stand or sit in this chapel as the perfect, asking God for mercy on sinners, but like the tax collector in the Gospel, we ask the Lord to have mercy on these sinners, as we are sinners too. We do this because it is right, just, necessary, and good. We beseech Almighty God, therefore, for his mercy on our souls and on all those who have left the church, particularly his priests who have abandoned the priesthood. We ask for those who have configured in a special way to Jesus Christ to be instruments of his salvation in the world, might be worthy by his grace of that calling, that they might hear the words of eternal life, not those words that were said by our Holy Father St. Norbert in that prayer, they save others, themselves they cannot save. Let us beseech the Lord daily for his mercy upon us and upon the whole world, particularly in this month dedicated to the precious blood, the blood that cries out more insistently than Abel's. Let us pray that that blood, shed for us and for all mankind, will be efficacious in every soul, so that all might be brought to Christ. Blessed James Kern,
pray for us.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, this sacrifice of reconciliation and praise, which we offer to your majesty in commemoration of Blessed James Kern, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now enact. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Blessed James Kern you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sanctus.
similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice and bestowed it in their humble hands. And once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim.
Your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious intercession of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty for the gifts that you have given us. This pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones who are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angels to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who prove this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in a state of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who seek in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, open your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Glory be to Jesus, who in this happens, offer me the life blood from his sacred hands. Grace and life is drowned in that blood I found. Blessed be his compassion, infinitely.
Sacrament, Lord, we pray, lead us always in your love through the example of Blessed James Kern, and bring to fulfillment the good work you have begun in us until the day of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
And thanks be to God.